I'm Reggie Ponder, the real critic, and this is the 511. That's movie information in 51 seconds by one critic. That's me, starting.
This is paradise.
This is what we need.
Every year, four couples get together.
I asked Marcus for the password to his cell phone.
What did he say?
What? To try to answer one question.
Why did I get married?
Why did I get married to?
This week's movie is Tyler Perry's Why Did I Get Married 2. Like the original, this film looks at marriage from different perspectives, but this one is more of a dramedy, because in addition to seeing Tasha Smith go overly dramatic trying to control her husband, it feels more serious than the original. Now don't get me wrong, you will laugh and probably miss some of the dialogue in the process, but they try to touch on various issues affecting a marriage, including unemployment, jealousy, cheating, anger, forgiveness, and yes, redemption. Now all the old characters are back, with a few new ones as Perry continues to provide opportunities for veteran black actors. Also true to Perry's formula is that some of this does feel stereotypical, but with four different couples, we get more than the standard worn-out story with a clear message that marriage is about love and trust.
I know how to listen to that voice on the inside that tells me when a man is cheating.
Get out of here.
You're about to lose your wife.
And one of these couples...
What, you don't want people to know we have a problem?
You okay? We're fine.
Will not make it.
There's got to be something in them 14 years that's worth fighting for.
You can only fight with a person when they're willing to get in the ring with you.
Can there be more depth? Yes. Can there be a better film? Yes. But does Perry make it work? Yes. He makes us laugh, think, and stimulate the discussion about marriage. Why Did I Get Married 2 is worth watching. A good time. Three reels. See you next week.
I'm Reggie Ponder, the real critic.